स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दम् कृपा पूर्णम् जगत्पतिम् हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम् नित्यानन्द गुरुम् भजे.
Let me express a main word, key word. I can call this word as Mahavakya. Mahavakya, the word which you need to completely understand. Maybe modern day Mahavakya. The word is unclutched. Be unclutched. That is the Mahavakya. Now, let us try to analyze, understand and internalize this one truth. One Mahavakya. We have beautiful different Mahavakyas in Vedic tradition. Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi. So many wonderful Mahavakyas. Ayamanma Brahma, Prajnanam Brahmam, Sarvangalvidam Brahmam. These are all different Mahavakyas. Be unclutched. What do I mean by the word being unclutched? Let me try to explain it with a simple diagram. How continuously our mind is working and how we are clutching, connecting and creating a life or suffering, how we are creating the ignorance or depression. Let me describe, then you will be able to understand what do I mean by the word unclutching. Please come back if you have changed the channel in between. Now it is time. We enter into the satya, the truth. The real experience of atato brahma jignyasat happening. Means let us inquire into the reality. And have courage to go into the experience wherever the reality leads. How our mind works. How we create thoughts and how we give meaning to it and how we experience life. A simple diagram. I'll try to explain. For example, the thoughts are happening in your system. These are all different thoughts. I'm just trying to give. Kind of a diagram. Different shape, different size, different length or different width, different kinds of thoughts. Sometime thought is about some joyful experience which you had. Sometime some suffering which you had, or sometime some guilt thoughts, or sometime again some joyful memories, sometime some painful memories, then again some depressing memories, sometime again then some suffering, different thoughts. If you just do a simple experiment, just for 5 minutes, if you write whatever comes without editing as it is, whatever goes inside, without editing, as it is, and read that page again, suddenly you will realize you are nothing but a bunch of unconnected, independent, illogical, unclutched parts. Please understand. The thinking flow which is happening inside you is not logically connected. For example, if you see a dog in the street, suddenly you will remember the dogs which you have seen when you were a child, or the dogs about which you used to be afraid, you are frightened. Then you will remember your childhood days. Then you will remember the teacher under whom you studied. Then you will remember the place where the teacher stayed. The thought chain, the link will go on. But there is no logical connection between the dog which you saw in front of you in the street and the teacher with whom you studied when you were young. Of course, both of them barked at you, shouted at you. There is no logical connection. Suddenly from where the mind moves to where, there is no logical connection. If you study deeply and you go back to your house, try this experiment just for 5 minutes. Just for 5 minutes, keep alarm, pen down whatever comes. If you think no thoughts are coming, write that also. Whatever goes inside, in the West they have a dragon software, all the doctors use for medical transcription. Whatever you speak, it'll transcribe. I also use some time for writing books. If your mind is connected to a dragon software, how it will transcribe? Transcribe the same way, whatever goes on inside, with the same kind of grammatical errors, or same accent, or the same pronunciation, or same words, even if it does not make any sense, just pen down. Suddenly you will see you are nothing but a bunch of independent, illogical, unconnected, unclutched thoughts. You do not know why particular thought is raising after a particular thought. There is no logical reason. There is no logical reason. Just something arises, and then next something else is arising. Next, something else is arising. Thoughts are flowing. Words are flowing. When you are aware, usually, sometime suddenly you will become aware of your body and your existence. At those moments, any thought which flows in front of you becomes your life. You start giving attention to it, either to fulfill or to escape. Understand? It's like a projector light is there. Any slide which is kept in front of that projector light is seen as a reality in the screen. One problem is this: in your inner space, the projector light is not continuously on. It just comes and goes, comes and goes. Whenever you are not aware of your existence, many times, even though your eyes are open, even though your body is moving, you will not be aware of your existence. You can see in your life, you will get into your car in your house, drive for half an hour, only after you reach the office, park the car, and when you come out of the car, suddenly you will realize, oh, I finished my driving. Office come. I reached office. You would have taken 200 decisions in that half an hour. Right, left, giving brake, stopping for signal, but you are not aware of your existence. That is why you don't remember all these decisions you took and all these things happened in you. Means those few moments, the flash, the projector light was off. Any slide which was moving in front of it is not part of your life. Again, for no reason, the light comes on. When the light is on, when you are aware that you exist, whatever thought moves in front of you, they become your part. They become your life. Understand? It's a very subtle truth. Your life is totality of all the thoughts moving in front of you. But unfortunately, many times, many major decisions, thoughts, the life-changing incidents happens when you are not aware. It's like this film which moves when the projector light was off, that also is part of your life, part of your biography. But unfortunately, you are not aware of the scenes, decisions, thoughts which went on, which contributes to your life, which is also part of your life just because the light is off. Every single moment which passes in your life without you being aware of this moment of your presence is suffering. Either directly or indirectly, it will add to suffering. Either directly you will invite or indirectly you will create a situation for the suffering. It's a very important thing. How, when you turn your cars, the indicators blink. Same way, your consciousness also blinks. You do not know when it is on, when it is off. If you just see the thought flow in front of you, suddenly you will realize, oh God, all these things are going on in me. Then what is going on inside me? I myself do not know where I am heading. I myself do not know what is happening in me. Here, understand this diagram, then we will see more deeper and deeper truths. First, I wanted all of you to understand, you are not aware of all the decisions, all the thoughts moving inside you, inspiring you to live the way in which you are living, inspiring you to think the way in which you are thinking, inspiring you to be the way you are. You are not aware. But constantly we believe we are aware. That is the first illusion. That is the first illusion. The second, whenever I say this point, people get frightened. People feel frightened. Oh God, already I have enough suffering. Now he is adding one more suffering and one more fear that I do not know where I am heading. Understand? I am not adding suffering. I am just helping you to experience, open up to the reality. One more thing. Opening up to reality, even though it feels like suffering in the initial level, will always lead you to the joy and bliss. Because Sat, by its very nature, is Chit. Sat means the truth. By its very nature is Chit, means power, consciousness. And Ananda, bliss. By its very nature, Sat leads to Chit and Chit leads to Ananda. Even though in the initial level it feels like little more responsibility, little more load. Now itself already many of your mind would have decided, no. What he says may be right, that I am not aware of everything happening in front of me, but I can't Become aware of everything happening in front of me. Oh, living in the present moment, being aware of whatever is going on, that and all is not for me. I tried many times, Swamiji, you don't know how many techniques I tried. Understand, we are not that dumb as we think. We are not that dumb as we think. We have huge possibility, huge potentiality. Maybe the right initiation has not happened. The right click has not happened. So don't close the file. No, 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 I tried many times. You don't know how many gurus I went and how many techniques I tried. There are many people. I call them professional seekers. Their profession is seeking. Anywhere, any board, any Swami, any Guru, any saint, any Baba, any Mahatma, any Amma, anybody, they will be there. Not for learning, just for judging. What he is teaching, let me see. People come to me and ask me, I know everything, Swami, just give me in essence what extra you can add to me. I tell them, please, sorry, I don't know anything extra to add you. I can only remove something from you. What you think as knowledge, I can remove that so that the truth can happen. Please do not come to the decision, no, no, he's again, I think, going to teach living in the present moment. I know, I tried many times, it does not work out, and even if it works out, sometime it goes away. No, I am not going to teach you in living in the present moment. Because you are living, why should I teach? Even if you are suffering about your past, you are suffering in the present. Even if you are worrying about your future, you are worrying in the present. So you are in the present. I am not going to teach you to be in the present. All I am doing is trying to take away some ideas which you think as your mind. The first truth is you are not aware of all the things which is happening in front of you. You do not remember your biography as it happened. That is the first truth. You remember only as you want it. People ask me. Many times I tell them, if your thought per second, TPS, I call it TPS, thoughts per second, if it comes down, you will have clarity about your past and future. They tell me, what? About past? Already I have clarity. Why should I have about clarity about my past by bringing the TPS down? Now itself I know my past. No. Please understand, you don't know your past. You don't remember, recollect the past as it happened. You recollect only as you want it. Not as it happened. Just a simple example here. See, if your life was filled with different kinds of incidents, joy, suffering, guilt, joy, pain, depression, sad, different quality of incidents. You do not look at the life as it is. Usually what you do, what we do, I use the word we because sometimes people think that the word you means too condescending. That's the reason I use the word we. The problem is, in the public place, you can neither use we nor use you. If I say you, somebody feels condescending. If I use the word we, if you also have the same problem, how can you teach me? That is the big problem. Anyhow, because I don't have any other word, better to use the word we. What usually we do? Some joy, some suffering, some guilt, some joy, some pain, some death. This is our life, different thoughts, different experiences. Usually, you collect only all the suffering-related incidents and create a shaft, create a connecting idea and think your life is nothing but suffering. Understand? You collect the suffering, guilt, pain, depression, suffering, all these kinds of thoughts, connect them and you think your life is a long chain of a suffering. Your life is a pain shaft. I have seen people, the moment I ask, how are you? You are from where? First thing they will, everybody invariably starts, you don't know Swamiji, nobody has suffered like me in the life. This is a common introduction for their biography. Even my enemies should not suffer the amount of suffering I went through, Swamiji. Even in that, they want to be in the top. Even in suffering, they want to be in the top. Not second. Nobody has suffered like me, Swamiji. You don't know. Even in that, we have to be in the top. And not only that. See, not just they tell this to me, they believe strongly this. They forget the joyful incidents which happened in between. The joyful incidents, joyful memories which happens in between. They collect only the negative things, connect them and create a shaft. I call this as pain shaft. Pain shaft. Very rarely, sometime you create a joy shaft, but very rare, not only number, even the quality will be very rare. You collect the joyful incidents and create a joy shaft. Means you feel life is joy. But most of the time, you collect all the painful memories and incidents and create an idea, life is pain. Understand? If you create the shaft, life is pain, the problem will be, you will be just waiting for more and more painful incidents to be added. Anything you believe, you start believing, you will collect more and more experience and argument to strengthen that belief. Once you believe your life is a long pain shaft, that's enough. You will be just waiting to pick up only the painful incidents and elongate that shaft. You will be just waiting. You will never be able to remember or respect the joyful things happening in your life. You will continuously wait. Next, when is pain? When is pain? When is pain? And you will add. You will be waiting, meditating for pain. You will be meditating for pain. I have seen people just waiting to add that, elongate the pain shaft. Just waiting to add how the pain shaft can be elongated. One important thing we need to understand, believing that life is a pain shaft or believing the life is a joy shaft. The continuous incidents of joyful things. Life is continuous happenings of painful things. The moment you believe life is a continuous happening of painful things, unconsciously you will try to strengthen the belief, but consciously you will try to break the pain shaft. Understand? Unconsciously, what you will be doing? You will be continuously collecting more and more painful memories and incidents to strengthen your belief, strengthen the idea. But consciously, you will be trying to break. Big problem is, neither you can break the pain shaft, nor you can add to the joy shaft, because both shaft does not exist. It is just your memory. Please understand. The reality happening is this main line. Different memories, incidents continuously flowing. And that is also not connected logically. That is why I have given gap between every thought, different shape, different size, it just comes and disappears, just it's happening. If you think your life is big pain shaft, a chain of painful incidents, then you will pick up only the painful things and add. I have seen people carrying the memory, a very huge memory. The other day, one guy came to me and said, Swamiji, I'm going to divorce, please bless me. I said, usually we bless only for marriage, not for divorce. Can you tell me the reason? Let me analyze. The other day I was reading an article, I don't know how much it is true. 33% is divorce rate in Bangalore. I don't know how much it is true. I pray that it should not be true. In the West, 59% single homes. Understand? And 47% of the people die without having a close friend or a relative to receive the body. Body is taken by some professional organizations, undertakers, professional undertakers. It is just too much. This guy came and asked me, I'm going to divorce, please bless me. I said, first let us analyze why you are going to do, then we'll try to sort out. He said, that and all you don't know, Swamiji, you just bless me. I said, I cannot bless as you want. Only if I am convinced I can bless. And it's not like something I have and you can take it without my will. You can't steal blessings, fortunately. He said, the actual reason, the immediate cause was, she brought coffee and it spilled on the cloth, that's all. I asked, don't you see clearly, it is not enough reason for divorce. Why don't you realize, why don't you understand? He said, you don't know, Swami. Today she will pour coffee, tomorrow she will pour acid, you don't know. No, he said actually he told me, you don't know, today she will pour coffee, tomorrow she will pour acid. I said, why don't you be little logical? Why don't you be little truthful? How can you connect coffee and acid? Sometime it feels same. How can you connect coffee and acid? Don't you see the gap is too much? You are creating too much of ideas in your head. You are creating too many things. He said, no, no, Swamiji, you don't know. Last 10 years, how much I suffered with her, you don't know. I told him, do not just create a pain shaft. Just come out with incidents. Then we can analyze, look into it. Don't create a pain shaft. Pain shaft will stay only if you are unconscious. Please understand. Your opinion about life as pain shaft or joy shaft will stay only as long as you are unconscious. Not when you are aware. I told him, just come out. Incident by incident, let us analyze. He started telling me, in South India, there is a habit, during marriage, in a small pot, they will put a ring, and the bride and bridegroom, both of them are supposed to try to pick up that ring. Whoever gets it, it's theirs. It's a small game. These are all done in those days, only during marriage, the bride and bridegroom will see each other. So it's like a technique for zeroing down the distance. Just to zero down the distance, this kind of simple plays are done. This guy is saying, Swamiji, even during that play, she scratched my hand with a nail. Now see the file he is carrying in his head. I was really surprised. From there he started telling me, after 2-3 minutes I told, stop. Much worse than police record. I said, I think you should not ask divorce, she should ask. Living with you, she should ask. Now this is what we are doing continuously, sometime about others, sometime about ourselves. But constantly we create a pain shaft or joy shaft. One important thing we forget. Neither we elongate the pain shaft, nor we, neither we can break the pain shaft, nor we can elongate the joy shaft, because it does not exist. It does not exist. Just try to elongate the joyful moments. Try to hold on. If some joy happens, try to hold on to that experience. It won't stay. Not only that, try to reproduce the same ambience, same people, same place, same thing, everything, even the same temperature again. You will not have that same joy. Addiction means believing that joy or ecstasy came due to some object or person or situation, and trying to reproduce the same thing again and again, even though the same joy or experience does not come back again. Understand? This is the definition of addiction. Trying to elongate the joy shaft by recreating or reproducing or again bringing the same persons, situations or incidents or the happenings in your life. If you try, knowing that same joy is not coming is what I call addiction. Anything. Some people are addicted to partying. Some people are addicted to smoking. Some people are addicted to drinking. Some people are addicted even to newspaper reading. Especially the violent things. You do not know how much of violence we are swallowing. Understand? The more and more violence you swallow, you will become aware only if the violent pictures are moving in front of you. Means, the projector light which is in front of, inside you, the awareness that you exist, will come to life only when the violent thoughts cross in front of you. Because whatever you cherish, it's like alarm clock. You tell yourself, oh, I cherish this kind of thoughts. When those kind of thoughts are coming in front of my mind, please wake me up. It's an automatic alarm clock. If you are enjoying lustful thoughts, whenever lustful thoughts crash your system, you will come to the awareness, I exist. If you are enjoying violence, whenever the violent thoughts come in your system, you will come to life, that I exist. If you come to life, that I exist, the thoughts will get strengthened and empowered. If you empower a particular thought again and again, when those thoughts cross your inner space, you will come back to life. It will become vicious circle. This is what I call vicious circle. You empowering negativity and negativity bringing you back to life. You empowering again the more negativity and the more negativity bringing you to life and excitement. That is why if you start cherishing violence, please understand, if you start cherishing violence, you don't have to reach hell, you are in hell. Even if you reach, you won't find any difference. You won't find any difference. See, I am not talking about getting the information about life, some accident, some murder. These are all knowing about life to be safe. That is not I am talking about. Many times we enjoy violence, reading tabloids and seeing violent things in the media. especially reading tabloids. It's called letters, they call it selling violence. Very strong words are there. I don't want to use those strong words. Selling violence. The other day I was reading an article very scientifically, with the scientific data and statistics. They say in any city, if the boxing competition or boxing programs happen, what do you call in India? Same boxing. Fighting. This kind of programs happen, the public programs, I think in India it doesn't happen. In the West it is very common. Boxing fighting happens, within 30 days the crime rate of the city goes up by 30%. You'll be surprised. Same way, the other study, if a group of people meditate sitting in the center of the city, within 30 days, 67% crime rate comes down. It's done by one of the leading organization teaching meditation, Maharishi Mahesh Yogi's TM group. They have done this research in so many cities and proved it. Anyhow, see, they can afford to have this boxing, this violent programs, because they have infrastructure to control the society, to manage the society. There is no county, there is no village without police station. If you just call 911 in USA, within 3 minutes, you will see a cop standing in front of your home to take care of you, attend you. We can't afford to copy, duplicate, bring the same violence in our society. Our country is running because of Ramayana and Mahabharata, not by any law enforcement force. With all our infrastructure, we can maintain only a small percentage of our country. Our country runs by cosmic constitution, the eternal cosmic constitution. We call it Sanatana Dharma. So we can't afford to break it. I want all our intellectuals to understand. Please understand. The Indian intellectuals should understand. We can't afford to break our Dharma. We don't have a replacing infrastructure if we dump our Dharma. We don't have something to replace and maintain the social balance if we are going to dump our Dharma. We are swallowing too much of violence. Too much of violence, too much of this tabloid ideas. I've seen. See this, if you see the people who read these weekly tabloids, these idiotic things, you will see very low level consciousness. They will be constantly attracting accidents in their life, suffering in their life, because they are just waiting for painful incidents that gives them excitement. Kind of a very beautiful example by Ramana Maharshi. The dog will try to bite the dry bone, biting, biting, biting. The bone will poke the mouth. From its own mouth, the blood will come out. The dog will think that blood is coming from the bone and drink the blood, enjoy that blood. Exactly same thing happens in you when you swallow violence, when you eat violence, when you are digesting violence. Save yourself from violence. Understand, not just by the physical violence, even the psychological violence, which is constantly getting added into the society, into our system, by too many sources. If violence excites you, you will be waiting for that kind of incidents in your life. If pain excites you, if you believe life is pain shaft, you will be waiting for that kind of incidents in your life. and strengthen your belief. Understand? This is an important truth. The depression or low mood which you experienced 10 years ago, the depression or low mood which you experienced 9 years ago, the depression which you experienced 8 years ago, the depression which you experienced 1 year ago, they are all independent experiences happened in your life because of independent incidents. 10 years ago you would have been in depression because you don't have son. 4 years ago you may be in depression because you have a son. It is independent incidents causing independent experiences. But in the inner space, for the sake of convenience, you archive all the sufferings in one file for easy remembrance and easy reference. When you archive them all in one file, by and by, you start thinking, you connect all these depression experiences and come to an idea, my last 10 year life was depression. No. All 10 different depression experience happened in you, happened due to different reason, different time, different experience. But when you connect all of them and see, you come to an idea, last 9 years I was in depression. The moment you come to an idea, I was in depression last 9 years. Now you created an enemy who does not exist. Now you start fighting with him. I have to come out of depression. What to do? The moment you create a shaft, last 9 years you were in depression. Now you know for sure, next 9 years you are going to be in depression. You will say, yes, last 9 years I was in depression. Then naturally tomorrow morning I am going to be in depression. How can I suddenly come out? How is it going to happen? I am going to be in depression. Passive agreement with your enemy. Understand? First thing, you create an enemy who does not exist. Second thing, you already made a passive agreement with your enemy. You won the game. Then how do you think you will not attract depression? You created an enemy who does not exist. And already created a passive agreement with him that you won the game. Then naturally then you say, no, Swamiji, I am in depression. Please do something. My presence cannot help. Only your presence can help you. Your presence only can help you. Nothing else can be done. Same way, the pain. People come and tell me, Swamiji, last 20 years I have knee pain. No. It cannot be. Please understand, it cannot be. I am not disrespecting you or adding more suffering to you by saying all problems are in your head. No, I am not disrespecting you. I am just telling you the truth. All problems are in your head. Please understand, I am not disrespecting you by saying, I am just stating the truth. The knee pain which you experienced 2 years ago, the knee pain which you experienced 1 year ago, the knee pain which you experienced 2 months ago, the knee pain which you experienced 2 hours ago, are independent experiences. When you connect them and see, you stop the possibility of self-healing. Please understand. You stop the possibility of self-healing. Whether you believe it or not, medical science proves your body constantly updates itself and replaces itself once in every 365 days. Even your brain cells are replaced once in 365 days. The intestine is replaced once in 47 days. Every organ is replaced within a particular number of days. If you are carrying a particular disease for quite a long time, it means you have a strong belief it is a continuous shaft. It is a continuous experience. Your unconscious belief, something is a continuous experience, forces your mind to bring the same pain and disease back. For example, once in 47 days, your intestine gets replaced completely. Understand? I am not saying. Ayurveda is not telling. If Ayurveda says, you won't believe. Medical science is telling. The logical, allopathy medical science is saying, once in 47 days, your intestine cells are completely replaced. If you are carrying any disease related to more than 47 days, even the new system which you created with a mental setup, I have this problem, so I have to have this problem. Strong belief, you have this problem, naturally you will say, if new intestine is given to you, no, this is not mine, bring mine. This is not mine, bring mine. Have you heard the story in those days? A young age, one woodcutter was there, he was cutting a tree near the river, and his axe fell in the water. One goddess appeared and she brought a golden axe and asked, is it yours? He said, no. Then she brought silver. She asked, is it yours? He said, no. Then she brought his axe made out of iron. Yeah, she asked, is it yours? He said, yes, it is mine. Then she is very pleased and she handed over all the three. You would have heard the story. Understand, in that story, it is okay. But I wanted to tell you the extension of the story. Now, second edition has come. Same hunter was cutting the tree on the same river. He was being assisted by his wife. Suddenly, by mistake, the wife fell in the river. And the goddess appeared, brought a beautiful woman. Young, beautiful, then the wife, and asked, is she your wife? This guy said, yes. And goddess got very annoyed, and she got angry. How dare you, greedy fellow? Last time with axe, you told the truth, but now with the wife, you are telling the lie? He says, no, you don't understand my problem. Last time you asked, first gold, then silver, then my axe. When I said it is mine, you gave all three. Now again, if you give three women to me, what will I do? I know with one what suffering I am going through. That is the reason I took precautious steps. I just wanted to stop with one. Anything is okay, but just send one, not second. Anyhow, just like how the goddess is asking something better than yours, is it yours? Same way, every time the Parashakti is asking, is this your new body? She is creating new body, the nature, the self-healing energy which resides in you. That is what is Parashakti, your mother's part, understand? The energy which is inside your body and rejuvenates yourself is the part contributed to you by your mother. It's from your mother, Parashakti. Your mother is a representation of the cosmic mother. So when cosmic mother comes and says, is this new intestine is yours? You say, no, bring my old one. Your mental setup is such. We strongly believe the depression or disease is a shaft happening inside us. It is not. It is not. The depression you experienced 10 years ago, the depression you experienced 9 years ago, the depression you experienced 8 years ago are independent, unconnected incidents, experiences. When you connect all of them and see, You created a pain shaft, depression shaft. Oh, my life is depression. Now, you are ready to get defeated by the unknown enemy. One important thing, this is a very basic truth. Neither you can break the shaft, nor you can elongate the shaft, because the shaft does not exist. All you can do is just be aware that it does not exist. You created it. Understand? For the sake of convenience and easy reference, you put all the depression incidents in one file and kept. By and by you started believing all of them are existentially connected. No. They are not existentially connected. All your different experiences. One more thing. The moment you believe all your depression is connected and you are a depressed being, the small joyful things happened in between will be forgotten by you. You will not even remember them. Understand? You will not even remember them. That is what I am saying. Not having clear picture about past. If you have a clear picture about your past, it will become a solid experience. It will not be a load. It will become a strength. Undigested past is a load. Digested past is a strength. We don't digest our past. It stays on us like a load, like a headache. Here, when you connect all the painful incidents and create a pain shaft, you create an enemy who does not exist and start fighting with him. You see, understand? I am repeating some of the words again and again, because suddenly you might have changed the channel for the sake of people who are tuning in just now. CNN and I have seen, they read the news, suddenly they'll say, welcome to the people who are tuning in just now, headlines once more. That's the reason. I am reading the headlines again and again. If it is little boring, please bear with me. I am repeating so that it can enter into the system. Somebody asked Buddha, why are you repeating the same thing for 40 years? He says, if you would have heard first time, why do you think I will repeat second time? The shaft does not exist. Basically, you are an independent, illogical, irresponsible. No two thoughts are responsible for others' existence or disappearance. Understand? No two thoughts are responsible for other thoughts' existence or disappearance. Illogical, independent, irresponsible, unconnected, unclutched thoughts. But you are afraid to live with such an undefined frame of mind. You are afraid to live with undefined mind. So you try to define. You trying to define is the first problem. When you try to define, you have to create some shaft, either as pain or as joy. Understand? Even with your spouse, you live maximum 6 months. Maximum 6 months, we live. Within 6 months, we create an idea about that person. After that, you live only with the idea which you have about that person, not with the spouse. Anything the other person does, you will look through that idea only. 6 months, you will come to an idea. Oh, this is the punishment given to me by God. Or, I don't have to go to hell after death. Some idea. You will see continuously whatever she or he does through that scale, through that idea, through that mirror, through that glass. You don't live with the person. You live with the concept. Same way, about your mind, you have an idea, your pain shaft or joy shaft. You live with that shaft, not with the experience. In experience, joy, pain, everything, so many things are coming up. So many things are happening. One more thing. Between every thought, there is a gap. Understand? It's like a fish tank. Water bubbles are coming in the fish tank. Between every bubble, there is a gap. Because the gap is too small, you think it's a stream. It is not stream. Between every thought, there is a gap. There is a gap. It is just independent, illogical thoughts moving. The problem is, when you can't live with that, when you don't want to live with that independent, illogical movements, you create an idea, pain shaft or joy shaft, and struggle with it. You create an enemy who does not exist and fight with it. Fight with that person.
Shivoham.